For international medical graduates who want to work in the United States, there are some changes around the corner in the process. Starting in 2024, IMGs who want to apply for a medical-based certification must be graduates from schools accredited by the World Federation for Medical Education, the WFME. Hello, my name is Mark. Welcome to the channel. On this channel, I provide information and communication tips for IMGs who want to work in the United States. Thank you for stopping by. In previous videos, we have talked about the Educational Commission for Foreign Medical Graduates, the ECFMG. The ECFMG is the only organization that verifies international medical graduates' credentials for work in U.S. hospitals. As stated earlier, IMGs who want to work in the U.S. must be graduates from a WFME-accredited school. Today, let's take a look at the countries covered by the WFME and the countries currently covered under ECFMG pathways. As of August 2022, the WFME has accredited a number of countries' medical education agencies. This means that they have determined that the organizations meet quality standards in medicine and training. With the 2024 rule, this places a burden on medical students in that the medical school must be an approved school. If you apply before 2024, the rule does not apply. However, your medical school must still be listed in the World Directory of Medical Schools, WDOMS. Why the change? Before 2020, the ECFMG used the United States Medical Licensing Exam, USMLE, series for IMGs. Indeed, American medical graduates also needed USMLE exams. In 2020, the pandemic put the in-person clinical encounter-based exam, the United States Medical Licensing Exam Step 2 Clinical Skills, on hold. The USMLE organization decided to abolish the exam in 2020. As a result, a new way to ensure IMGs met medical education and practice standards was needed. The pathways were created soon after. Now, let's look at the countries and agencies. I will not go over every agency. The Caribbean has two agencies. Different medical schools are covered under different agencies. TIPDAD covers a wide range of countries in the Middle East and Turkey. Canada and the US are covered. It would be impossible to think that they are not accredited. Both South Korea and Japan have agencies. Australia and New Zealand are covered under one agency. The IAAR covers a large number of ex-Soviet Union nations, as well as the Russian Federation. Georgia has its own organization. Thailand, Sudan, and Indonesia are represented. Dutch and Flemish speakers are recognized by one agency. Other covered countries include Mexico, Egypt, Brazil, Taiwan, Iran, the UAE, and Cyprus. China, Ireland, Jordan, Hungary, and Saudi Arabia are covered. In Spain, only the region of Catalonia has accreditation. As of August 2022, the following countries and their agencies are in the process of applying. It is difficult to determine if and when accreditation will take place. I hope for all IMGs that your country is successful in getting accredited. Germany and Austria, Bahrain, Lithuania, Cameroon, Morocco, Tunisia, Colombia, Israel, Grenada, Italy, Spain, the Philippines, Sri Lanka, Switzerland, Pakistan, India. In other videos, I have talked about pathways. Again, pathways are ways to fulfill the clinical or medical requirement for IMGs who want to be certified by the ECFMG. In particular, pathways 2 to 5 have specific requirements. Pathway 2 is an objective, structured clinical exam that is required for medical licensing. Pathway 3 is a WMFE accredited medical school. Pathway 4 is comparable with U.S. medical schools. Pathway 5 is a degree issued jointly with a U.S. medical school. This is the rarest pathway. As you will see, many countries are covered with a pathway already. Please check with the list on the ECFMG website to see if your school is on there. The link is below. Australia, Belgium, Brazil, and China can use Pathway 3. Bangladesh can use Pathway 2. The Czech Republic has Pathway 4. Pathway 4 is also okay for the Dominican Republic and Israel. Egypt, Georgia, Japan, and Indonesia can use Pathway 3. Other Pathway 3 countries are Iran, Malaysia, South Korea, Taiwan, and Saudi Arabia. Spain and Pakistan can use Pathway 2. Russia, Thailand, and Turkey can use Pathway 3. Poland has Pathway 4, and Singapore has one school, which is for Pathway 5. The Ukraine and the UAE have Pathway 3. The UK has Pathway 4. Please note that the information can change. The information is available on the ECFMG website as well as the WFME, and you can check WDOMS.org to see if your medical school is listed there in the tab stating that you are approved for the ECFMG. I know that for many international medical graduates, the situation is unclear, especially if your medical school and/or national accreditation organization is not approved or is going through approval. This information is for you to know roughly what the situation is and for you to make an informed choice. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you have found it useful. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments section below. If you like this video, please consider subscribing. Until the next video, have a good one.